Dear viewers and my fellow colleagues, a very good evening to you all. I welcome you all on the behalf of the Department of Clothing and Textiles on the ongoing Textile Week 2020. I would like to thank Professor Sudha Katyal, Principal, Government Home Science College, Chandigarh, for always motivating us and helping us to organize such events. Let me now introduce our creative expert for today, Mrs. Jaya Duggal, who has been taking these workshops since last year. She is a fashion designer, postgraduate science teacher, and a trained fevicryl artist. She is also a passionate home chef and conducts trainings for homemade chocolates and healthy recipes. We welcome you, ma'am, and hope to learn this great art form from you today. Now I invite Mrs. Simar Prabh Kaur to give us a glimpse of this fading art form, which is called Rogan art, and what is its process. So over to you, Simar ma'am. Ma'am, please unmute yourself.
Thank you, Chandana. A very good evening to one and all. As Chandana already told you that we are having a very interesting workshop inspired from Rogan art. So let's see what is Rogan art. Rogan art is an ancient textile art with its origin in Persia, came to Kutch around 300 years ago. Rogan is a form of textile painting. Rogan is a form of textile painting which uses a rich, highly colored paint made from castor oil and natural colors. The technique of Rogan is very interesting. As you can see in the above slide, the artisans place a very small amount of this color paste on their palm, and with the help of a metal rod, they pick these paint and twist them into motifs and patterns, into beautifully patterns. Then afterwards, the metal rod never come in contact with the fabric. Afterwards, the artisans fold the fabric, thereby printing its mirror image on the other half and creating a very symmetric designs. Though it is basic form of printing, but its designs are very intricate. Tree of life, paisleys, and stylized floral motifs are part of this textile art. So let's begin with this workshop. So we are not able to follow the old traditional method but with the use of contemporary material and colors, we can keep this traditional art form alive. So dear students, keep your material ready as we are about to begin. Over to our expert, Jaya ma'am.
Hello, good evening to all, and I welcome you all here. So today we are learning contemporary Rogan art. As ma'am has told you many things about Rogan art, so I'm just telling you how we can do with the help of fevicryl 3D outliners. I'm very thankful, and we should always be thankful to fevicryl to providing such product, so we can easily do the copy, we can say, of this art. Though traditionally we are not able to do with column or the natural colors, so with the help of 3D liners we can create the same art pattern. So we will start with this. Okay, as you all can see, I have traced the design of parsley. We are always doing this pattern on a base, black base or a blue base, any dark color base you can take. Okay, and you all know how to trace the design. I have traced the design with the help of white carbon paper, or you can use yellow carbon paper. Trace the design you like. Most of the design we are using, as ma'am told you, are parsley patterns or tree of life or peacock patterns or any geometrical patterns. Okay, so These are the 3D outliners. I'm using these 3D outliners. There are many colors available in these 3D outliners. So with the help of these 3D outliners, we are creating a contemporary Rogan art. I hope my voice is clear to you all. Hello, Chanda ma'am, my voice is clear.
Yes, ma'am, your voice is absolutely clear.
Ma'am, just reply me, my voice is clear.
Yes, ma'am, your voice is absolutely clear, ma'am.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. So I'll just start. First of all, think that as I have traced this design, first we will do the outline work. Okay, then we will do the intricate designing. So and start with the inner part so that the outer part will not spoil. Start with the inner part of the design. So I'll be starting with the flower. Okay, the colors I'm taking, I'll just tell you the name and the number mentioned on the colors. First, I have taken this blue color, pearl blue 305. Okay, and these are very easy to use. And suppose if the tube is not working, you have to prick with this safety pin on any pointed, any sharp object. So like this, when you move this tube, try to a bit upper, do not touch the cloth, so the outline will come very nice. Okay, a thick outline will come. You can see I have just marked the center. So in this way you need to move. I'm just taking second color for the more colors it will look more beautiful. So I'm using this pearl green. This is 304. Press properly, okay, and while give a good pressure and little above than your cloth. Okay, do not touch it with the cloth, then the outline will come very nicely. If you touch it with the cloth, then it will not be very fine. You can see it will give 3D effect. Now I'll be using yellow color. This is yellow 703. Always keep in mind that after using, once you are not using it, close it properly, otherwise the color will dry. As I told you that we need to mark the outline first, then we will do the intricate designing in the inner parts.
Sorry to interrupt you, ma'am. Can we bring it a little closer to the camera?
Is it fine now?
A little closer to the camera to show the technique to the students, how to start it. You can just pick your,
Now it's fine?
Yes, ma'am, it's fine now. But the
motive is not visible, right?
Yeah, motive is not
visible. Now, let me check, just. Now it's visible, ma'am?
Yes, it is visible, ma'am. Just bring it in a little center.
Little. Now?
Yes, ma'am. Now it's perfect. The tubes that you are using, can you just put it on the black color?
I'm just putting it here, okay?
Yes, so the children can see that.
Okay, I'm just putting it here, whatever the colors I'm using. Although there are so many shades available. So I'm just doing it with yellow. Okay, the flower outline I'm doing with yellow. I have marked a toll number also. This is 703. Maybe in the starting you find it little difficult to press. You have to give a good pressure so your lines will come perfect. Little above than the cloth. Not too much, little above than the cloth you need to work. Then your lines will come perfect. You can see. And you see the colors, how beautiful colors they are. Keep it just little above the cloth and give a pressure at the back of side of the tube. Okay, don't push it from here, press it from the back side of the tube. The inner part, inner designing, intricate designing is more important, and that gives a very nice effect that we will do later on. First, we will full outline of the design. Now I'm using orange shade, neon orange, that is 711. Only a little practice will give you a good finishing in this work. It looks very nice once it's complete. You can use in your handbags. You can make cushion covers as festive season is coming. You can make on bed sheets. And even you can use on your kurtis, denim. Okay. But always try to take a dark base color. You can even do in maroon color. It's not necessary on black. But if you take dark base, na, then all colors will look more beautiful on the dark base. You know, in this 3D liners, you will get metallic shade, you will get neon colors, and you will also get pearl shades. Okay? So you can take colors of your choice.
Ma'am, our viewers need a little closer look of the art that you are preparing. So just can you, if you can show it, bring it okay. Near to the camera. Bring it near to the camera. Yes.
Now?
The motif is not visible, ma'am.
Okay, let me turn this side.
Yes, now. Ma'am. Yes, now it is visible. So now you can just explain it. A brief explanation
okay.
of the whole process.
Okay. See, I'll just explain in brief. See, I have traced a motif of parsley. Then what I'm just saying that whatever the design you have traced, first you need to draw the outline of the design with the choice of your colors, whatever colors you want to take. Just draw the outline of the design. Once that outline is done, then only we'll do the intricate work. Always start from the inner part of the design and come towards the outer design. If you do outward and you go to inner side, then the outer side, if your hand touch it, it will spoil the design. So always start with the inner part of the design and come towards the outer part. So I've started with a circle inside and then flower, and I'm doing this part and then come towards the outer part. So I'm just giving the outline and then we will do the intricate work. It's okay to call? Ma'am, it's fine. Now I'll start.
Yes, ma'am. Perfect. Thank you so much, ma'am. You can continue, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. So I'm doing it with neon orange. I have told you the number. It's 711. Wherever you're doing, just tape your cloth tightly so this outline will come properly, or even you can put in embroidery frame if you are doing in a small piece of cloth. And as I've told you, while doing the outline, try not to touch with the cloth. A little above with the cloth you need to work, okay? And give a good pressure at the back side of the tube. And suppose it sometimes happens your tube is its color are not coming properly, then just prick with the help of the any sharp needle, or you can use a safety pin like this have come, so you can clean it like this also, pick it up with the help of any sharp pin. Okay, and if at the nozzle color collected, then also please clean your nozzle. And always while working also, it's not like if you're making this and one color you have used and you're using another color, just make sure that you have closed the last one, otherwise it will get dry. Although it's worked for more than 2 or 3 years, it won't dry, but if you will not keep it properly, then sure it will dry. Now I'm using outer lining. I'm giving it with green color again, pearl green 304. More colors you use, it will look more beautiful. Okay, so try to use at least 3-4 shades in your pattern. If you'll take Tree of Life, then you can use 3-4 colors, but in this I'm using 6 shades of Fevicol 3D outliner. Sometimes it can happen due to air inside, it come out like this, then no worries, just clean with the help of needle. And if the color is not coming, then also you can tap it like this at the end, then color will collect at the point and you can do it. See, I'll just prick it like this with the help of any pin, sharp pin, and tap it, then color will come. As ma'am told that in traditional form, they usually draw half part and fold the cloth, and symmetrically the other part will come. But in this, we cannot do that. We have to draw both the sides. We need to work like this. They almost have symmetrical pattern both the sides, either Tree of Life or Paisley pattern also.
Ma'am, we are also having some questions in the comment box.
Yes, ma'am. You can ask me that questions.
Yeah, there is one question that can we use it on our kurti or bed sheet? And yes, ma'am. If used, is it washable?
Yes, ma'am. Let it dry for at least for 24 hours and do not wash it for at least 7 days. Okay. Then you can use it on your kurti or bed sheets.
Okay, so you have to keep it for 7 days at least without wearing it. So even I want to add something that these are like these liners are applied on the surface, so I think these can't be washed in the washing machine though, but you can easily wash it with your hands only.
And that is applicable for all the embroidered designs. If you have very costly suit also, if a good design is there, good embroidery is there, we need not put these delicate clothes in washing machine. We need to wash it with hand or with gentle soaps.
Thank you, ma'am. And there is one other question, ma'am. You are drawing with, and there is a blank after that. So the issue is... I think she wants to ask, like, what is the material that you are using, you are working with?
I'm working on cotton fabric. You can use any fabric of your choice. It's not a restriction. But always iron that cloth, and as I told you, tighten it properly while working. These two things should be kept in mind.
So the fabric or anything, any surface that you are working on, it should be on a stretched canvas,
yeah,
or
it,
touched on an embroidery frame if the thing that you're working on is small.
Yeah, it should be stretched. And if you're working on a big, then like mudda, the embroidery persons are using, na, you need to stretch the cloth. So while you're working, na, so it should not turn or have a crease. Iron it properly and then stretch it properly so that neat work should be there. Na? It is basically like you work with, if the one, those are good in mehndi design, like you work with cone. In the same way you're working this with these cones.
Okay, same, so those who have interest in mehndi designing, they can make beautiful designs of Roman art fabrics as well.
Yeah, girls or boys even nowadays, those are very good in mehndi designing. They can do wonders with these 3D liners.
And there is one more question. Kya hum, like she wants to ask, can we use any other material except these 3D outliners?
No, because 3D outliners give a 3D effect. If you do with acrylic colors, the 3D effect will not come. And it's also very difficult to give very fine lines because it's very intricate work. So with acrylic colors, it's difficult to do. You can do with acrylic color, but it is difficult and 3D effect will not come. With this liners, na, it's look like embroidery. Even these liners were called liquid embroidery liners. So those who are not able to do needle and thread work with embroidery, it's very easy for those to work with these liners. They give a effect of embroidery. I hope I have cleared her question.
Yes, definitely, ma'am. I hope the students with their questions, they are getting their answers. So I'll get back to you with more questions, ma'am. You please carry on.
Yes, yes ma'am. Thank you. If any shade you people are not heard what shade I'm using, I can give you in writing. I will send it, whatever shades I'm using. I'm just doing the outlining part first. Once the outline part is complete, I will show you how to fill it. We need to fill the design. I hope you all are enjoying this art. This looks very beautiful. And as you all are textile designing students, I will surely advise you to make some good pieces for this. You can have a small purses or handbags out of it, this design. It will look very nice. So color combination is totally your choice, what colors you want to take. But choose bright colors. You also have an option of golden color in this, copper color. 12 shades are available, more than 12 shades are available. See, this effect is coming because of 3D liners. If you use acrylic colors, this 3D effect will not come. It is a flatten with acrylic colors, it is flattened. And all these shades come very beautiful in any dark color. You can even, I will also advise you, you can even make belts, broad belts. Now, girls can also make broad belts for their dresses. And even if you have cut a small piece, you can make funky necklaces out of it. That is also very that idea is very in nowadays, like Navratras are coming. So you can make funky necklaces and attach beads and something and wear that jewelry rather than going for a traditional if you want to in kurti on, rather than try something new, try on your belts, try on your jewelry, try for jewelry, it will look more beautiful. So as you can see, I've just given the outline of the design. I will show you one completed article also afterwards. As I've taken a small motif now, just to complete it on a time. Because it every art needs patience. If you do it patiently, then it will come more beautiful. No need to make any hurry. And art is a good stress buster also. So do it, you will enjoy. See how beautiful colors are coming. Although I've not even filled it. If you have any doubts, any question, you can ask me. Ma'am will ask your questions.
Yes, ma'am, we have two more questions with us.
Yes, ma'am.
So one question is, necklaces should be done on cloth itself or any base to be given?
No, ma'am, you can take the same. Even I have tried, I don't have it right now. You can take this cloth base, and at that base you can use, you must be knowing Bukram, that Teflon cloth on available on this tailoring material shop. So stick that with at the base of the cloth, so it will give stiffness to that necklace. Although it's not very stiff, take two layers of cloth and in between put that layer and give a design, and then draw do it loud line of work. In same work with belts also. In the same way you can design belts also. You can take two folds of cloth. I will show you with the help of tissue paper, although right now I'm not having any cloth. Suppose this is your cloth. You need to fold it like this. In between this layer you need to stick that Teflon cloth and iron it, and then you can cut any design. It will become stiff, and you can still stick, no need for stitching also. In Fabricil we have very good fabric glue, so you can stick the corners with the help of fabric glue and attach tassels or these beads. I will send you one picture I have of that, although that piece is not available with me. And one more question, ma'am, you were asking?
Yes, ma'am. How much time does it take to dry?
At least give 1 hour for proper drying. Although, see, it's dried, but as depends on weather also. Now, weather is changing, so it takes little more time to dry. If it's more humid and in winters, it takes time to dry. But at least give 1 hour.
Okay, ma'am.
Now, I hope my outline.
Students are getting their answers also side by side.
Yeah. So my outline part is done. You can see. Now we have to fill the design with intricate design. Okay, to give a nice look to my pattern. So I'll start with the center of the flower. I just put a point in the center. Okay, now I'm using pearl white colors to give dots. press it and pick it up. Press it and pick it up. Put dots like this. Okay? Press and pick it up. Like this. Okay? Now, inner part of the flower, again, I will fill it. First, I will give one more outline and then we will fill it. See. The more the fine design, the more beautiful it will look. So try to give intricate designs, okay? Don't make hurry, as I told you. Try to give fine designs. Always, as I've told you many times also, just close the bottles you are not using. And your tip of the color should always be clean while doing the intricate designs. Okay, see, two color combination have given a nice look to the flower. Now I'll be using green in it. Just putting the lines inside the flower. Okay. And if you see your outline is little bit because colors have merged, so you can just give outline once again. On that part only. Okay. Now again, outer part of the flower, I'm giving a dotted design with pearl white color. Press and up. Once it is dried, these beads, it will look like beads. Press and up, okay? Just don't do it like this. If you do it like this, it will look flat. So you have to press and up like this. This will give a beaded, it will look like beads, small beads you have put. If you just touch it like this, now if you touch it like this, see, it is flat. You can see the difference between this one and this. It is flat. If you want to have a 3D effect, just press it and up like this. Now it may be looking pointed, but once it is dry and settled, it will become like a pearl. See. Clear. I hope your queries have been resolved. If any more questions, you can ask me.
Yes, ma'am, we have some more questions.
Yes, ma'am. Always welcome.
Can we use molded for base and then wrap it with a cloth?
But why you want to use molded? What you want to create? These are basically fabric patterns. So why you want to do with molded? You can use it on molded. I don't have any issue, but it will work more on fabric. It depends what you want to create, right? You can use it colors, even outline, if you're doing an other base other than fabric. If it is Rogan art basically, but other than this, you can use these colors and fill any other colors also inside it. It works as an outliners. Now, I'll just show you.
Yes, students are asking what type of motifs come in Rogan art.
In Rogan art, basically, they use geometrical patterns, this parsley's, tree of life, peacock is also there. They just, as it is a traditional form of art, they have used the cultural design of Kutch part. This art is practiced in Kutch part of Gujarat. So they just take design from their culture. So it's not very specific, but the geometric patterns, parsleys, mostly you will see parsleys designs or tree of life. The tree of life is their favorite design. You will see so many artwork on tree of life. I hope its question is clear to her. Answer is yes, clear.
Yes, surely, ma'am. And there is one more question. Can we use 3D neon colors or outliners?
These are in this also, I'm using neon shades. I have told you that this is neon. This orange one is neon green, neon orange, and even this green is neon green is also there. You can use neon colors. But the bigger tubes are also there for neon. They are not that fine like these. That's why you're using the smaller tubes. It's easy to work with this. You can use that also. Basically, they also give you the 3D liner, outliner work. So you can use that also. In this, neon shades are available, pearl shades are available, and metallic shades are available. Three kinds of shades are available in these tubes. So you can use whatever you like. Now, Avia, I'm just filling in this inner part, okay? In orange, I'm just filling it. I'll show what type of design we need to fill in this. So I'm just taking blue one now. See, like you have seen the birds you do when you were small child, like this. Okay, fill it like this. Small birds kind of. Nowhere you will leave the more part of the fabric visible. Where the fabric part is visible, you need to give a small designing, intricate part of the designing. So pattern will look fully embroidered. The more you fill. If you leave it, then it will not look that intricate designing is not there. So just fill it. Fill the pattern, whatever, even small part is there, fill it with small dots, okay? If you feel you cannot give, a part is small, you cannot give any other designing, just fill it with dots. You all may be knowing the embroidery pattern designing, feather stitch and kantha stitch like this, you can fill the patterns. See, like this leaf stitch, we fill in the leaves. So you can fill that designing in the inner part of the design. Okay. Now again, I'm giving the dot patterns on the outer side of this design. Same. Put, drop and lift. Put, drop and lift upwards. Once this dry, now this dot point, that dot part looks more beautiful. Whatever part I feel that is more black is visible, no? Just fill with dots. Any more questions, ma'am? I hope students are enjoying this art. They will definitely make articles on this art. And I'll be really very exciting to see what they create after this art, contemporary art, using traditionally patterns of Rogan art and creating with 3D9. See, the inner part is completely filled, okay? Fine. Now, inside this yellow part, I will fill it with, we'll use pink color now. Make a V pattern like this, okay? V and center. V and center. As I told you in starting, the more intricate pattern you will create, it will look more beautiful. Chanda ma'am, any more questions?
It's already looking very beautiful, ma'am.
And thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much.
You might be very feeling very relaxing and peaceful while working on it.
Yes, ma'am. That's why I told even students, it's really a stress buster, especially during Corona days when you are not going out and you're feeling, sometimes you feel like they just, I always take any art form and practice it. It's very relaxing. Even the colors are very soothing. So it gives you peace of mind sitting at one place only. Have a good music and just enjoy this work and do it just patiently.
Yes, and I feel students can bring out more inventions or more innovative ideas with this beautiful art that is being dying. And it is our responsibility being fashion designing faculty and fashion designing students that we should not make this
on
art
this point
die.
I want to share to share one thing. Even I have read that you see, we know India is a rich culture having so many art forms and tradition. Even our honorable prime minister during his visit in 2014 in America, he's gifted this Tree of Life pattern to Barack Obama, US president, this pattern. So India is a rich culture of the East tradition. So we, as a student, as you told, even I'm a student of fashion designing. So you should bring these culture and tradition and even to out of India and show what India culture have and whatever the beautiful designs. Foreigners are always looking for Indian traditional art forms. We have a rich culture of different forms. So you can use your creativity and use this art form in many types rather than going for traditionally kurtis. As I've given you two ideas, I will love to see what you have created out of it. What out of focus things you have created.
Articles, like you already told about, they can make, they can use these motifs on their handbags, sling bags. Then they can make belts out of it, and they can do it on kurti as well, cushion covers. There are many ideas.
Yes, even if you are aware of this, barefooted, we wear a kind of jewelry, a circle on the feet. That is where in dance forms and all, you can create that also. So during these Navratras, na, people wear that kind of jewelry. So you can create that also. It also look very beautiful because pattern is looking like embroidery. So no one from far can judge whether it is embroidery or done with liners, because we know it is done with liners, we know. But people cannot judge us from far off that it is embroidery or we do it done with liners. So those are very no, very well not versed with embroidery patterns. They're not good with that. They can create any embroidery pattern using this liners.
Yes, it is already looking like a embroidered sample and embroidered art piece.
That's what I'm saying. If far
Customers are
off,
loving that.
people from far off, we cannot judge it. As it is
We
in
have a
contemporary, so
question
you can use it to. Yes, ma'am.
Can we use three glitters for this art?
I was just telling that although it is we are showing with 3D liners, but as is in a contemporary form of art, if you're going for jewelry or if you're going any belt piece, you can use some little bit stones also, glitters also, but glitter will not look like embroidery. We want to give it an embroidery look, so use 3D liners. But to enhance it, you can use some small this Swarovski stones or any stones in between. That will go with embroidery, but glitters will not give that good look. I don't prefer using glitters in this. Ma'am, your voice is interrupted or what? I mean, I'm not getting your voice.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, can we have a little closer look of the sample that you have made?
I'm doing or whatever I already have done.
Yes, ma'am, the one that you are doing.
Fine. More closer.
Yes, perfect, ma'am. It is very
I think it's
looking very
visible
beautiful.
now. Fine.
Yes, ma'am. You can continue, ma'am.
Once it is done, I will show you the completed how it looks after drying. See, okay. Now again, I will be using dot patterns. First, we will fill this, then we will use dot pattern like this. While making intricate patterns, now just make sure your tip of the color is clean. If color is there, just clean it once and then start working. Just put a tip and push it outwards. like this. Okay. Now this part also, between this red and yellow line, I'll make some small pattern. As I have told you, with no space, we will leave it like this. The more intricate design, more beautiful it will look. So need not to leave any space unworked. Make zigzag lines, make standing lines, okay? Just fill it completely. If a small part is there, you cannot fill it, just put dots on the small parts. If you see the design on that, it seems complicated in starting because of the intricate patterns. Just draw the trace the outline, start working. You will get the designs. In starting, it may seem difficult because of the entries. It seems so many small patterns filling inside. Like this. Now I will put some white drops in this part, a little bigger drops because we have more space, like this. See, it will look like beads. Press and up. I hope your all queries are resolved now. If still any query or any doubt, you're welcome to ask me. Now you see, now it's seeming difficult. Now where to start with? When you see the pattern, it will seem like this, where to start with. But gradually you can achieve the design, any design you like. Just have an outline and then fill it one by one. Just make sure while putting these drops have a generous amount of color so it will look like pearls, small pearls. Press it properly and press and up. Any questions, ma'am?
There is one question. Someone is asking, can we do it on our shoes, white or black sneakers?
Yes, you can try it on that also. It's also a very nice idea. You can try it in sticker. It's very trendy nowadays to paint your shoes, even. You can paint your juttis also with this. See, outer part also I'm making these dots, smaller dots. even you can take a broad bangle base, na? You can do on bangles also. Girls can do on bangles also. Jo thick wala, you can have thick bangles and cover it with cloth or satin ribbons, and above that you can do with this. Although it's little difficult to, as it is round surface, but you can always try on that also. Even on mobile covers, at the back of mobile covers also you can do. There are lot many options available. Because it works on any surface. These liners can work on any surface, so you can use it any surface. See, I hope you all are enjoying and loving this design. Once you are used to of this working with 3D liner, you will enjoy with working it, and you will work more with this. Maybe in starting you find it little difficult to press it, but once you are habitual of doing it, na, you will enjoy. So this is completed now. I will give you a closer look and I will show you the one complete pattern of two parsley designs. You can see this is done now. Okay. I think it's visible like this only. Although it's upside down, but in camera it's visible like this only. Just done. Okay. You can view it like this also. Right. Okay. It's visible now properly. Ma'am, it's visible now properly?
Yes, ma'am. It is looking really very beautiful.
You can see.
And we would like to see your
completed article. See. It look like this. So even in camera, you cannot judge whether it is embroidery or whether it is with 3D liner work. But once you see in person nearby, then only you can tell that it is not embroidery or it is liner. In camera also, I think you cannot judge. So it's the full pattern look like this. Although I have taken the half part to complete it in time. I hope you all are liking it. And you enjoy this art, and you make
it's love.
We'll love to see what you all create out of this. I have given you so many ideas.
Yes, and we are getting so many comments on your art. So beautiful, like color combination is so good. We are getting so many comments in our chat box, and everyone has liked, I hope.
Thank you. Even I will love to see what they have created. I have given so many ideas to them, even in jewelry, box, pens, this mobile covers. So even I would like love to see what they all create out of it.
Yes, probably, ma'am, our children are going to make beautiful articles out of it, and we'll definitely show you what they make.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you so much. And can we have you on the camera, please?
Just a second, ma'am.
Yeah, sure, ma'am.
I'll turn this only. It's fine now? Is it?
Yes, fine, ma'am. So I hope our students liked this workshop a lot, and they have learned a lot like there was one more question. What is the difference between liquid embroidery and rogan art? And I want to answer this question that rogan art is just a traditional art, and in liquid liners we can make any type of designs, any kind of illustrations, be it traditional or contemporary or modern. But for rogan art, we have to select the traditional motifs only, and we have got these liners for us to, like, the children, they can use these liners. Not if they don't get any traditional materials with them, they can always try traditional art forms, traditional dyeing art forms using the modern products available. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Welcome, ma'am. It's very easy with the help of these products. It's difficult to get a castor oil, and these are natural products, natural dye nowadays. So, but these are easily available. They can try these art forms and give life to these traditional art form with easily available materials. Even of course, in these times when necessary items are not available in COVID times, so getting that traditional forms, it's difficult. But you will get these liners in any stationery shop, and you can practice this art.
Yes, definitely, ma'am. On behalf of Professor Sudha Katyal, Principal Government Home Science College, Mrs. Chaya Verma, Head of the Department Clothing and Textiles, I would like to thank Mrs. Jaya Duggal for demonstrating this beautiful art form in an exciting way. I am also grateful to all those who have directly or indirectly contributed to this workshop. Our heartfelt thanks to our students for active participation. And I am sure all the students and our viewers will make use of this wonderful art form and help to revive this dying traditional art of Kutch. Thank you so much, everyone, for joining in today for this Fevicryl art workshop. And hope to see you soon, and would love to see the articles made by our students, definitely. Thank you so much, everyone, for your time.